You are listening to the Intelligent Vocalist Podcast, episode 135.
Welcome to the Intelligent Vocalist with John Henny. This is the podcast dedicated to help you be a smarter, better, more informed singer. And now, your host for the Intelligent Vocalist, John Henny.
Hey there, this is John Henny. Welcome back to another episode of The Intelligent Vocalist. I do so appreciate you spending your precious listening time with me. All right, I am releasing this podcast on Friday, November 15th, and my book, Voice Teacher Influencer, is now on Amazon.com. And tomorrow, depending on when you're listening to this, Saturday and Sunday, November 16th and 17th, my book will be free on Amazon Kindle. I will have the link on the show notes for this podcast. Just go to johnhenny.com/135 for episode 135, or you can just search Amazon for John Henny. And I'm also putting my first book, Teaching Contemporary Singing, on Kindle for free as well. So you can get both books this weekend for zero. I'm really excited. If you are thinking about being a voice teacher, if you're looking at teaching contemporary singing, want to get a little stronger in that area, my book, Teaching Contemporary Singing, can certainly help. And then Voice Teacher Influencer will show you how to grow your studio so you can have a thriving business and even make passive income, which is very, very difficult for teachers. So be sure to jump on that. All right. I was doing a little bit of Netflix watching, and I don't get to watch as much as I'd like. But I started to watch a movie called The Game Changers, and it is basically vegan, plant-based propaganda, but sometimes propaganda is good if you're trying to get your head in a certain place. And it's about athletes who eat a plant-based diet. And I am all for vegan propaganda in my life because I am convinced that eating plants saved my life. If you've been listening to the podcast, I've certainly mentioned it before, but I lost 150 pounds by eating plants, my high blood pressure went away, all types of ailments went away. So I am a huge fan of the plant-based diet. I know some people like to eat keto, paleo, whatever floats your boat, but I'm in the plant-based group. No desire to debate nutrition. I just know what works for me. And actually, the two people that led me to health, Ray Cronise primarily, and then his partner, Juliana Hever, they have a new podcast called Science and Saucery. So if you're interested in health span and longevity, and that's the main reason I eat plants now. I mean, I lost all the weight and lost it very quickly, 150 pounds in 8 months, but I've kept it off for 2 years. I'm essentially the same weight. I actually purposely added a few pounds just because I got a little too thin. I eat it now because of just the health span and the lifespan research. But their new podcast, Science and Saucery, digs into that. I highly recommend it. I'll put a link to it in the show notes as well, johnhenny.com/135. While I was watching this movie, I've admittedly only seen like the first 15, 20 minutes, but I will finish it. But it starts off with a MMA fighter who injures himself, and he starts to do a lot of research into nutrition. Of course, it leads him to plants, or else they wouldn't put him in the movie. But he was a huge fan of Bruce Lee, and he was taking some of Bruce Lee's philosophy to help guide him in his research. And I found Bruce Lee's maxims, Bruce Lee's philosophy, really applicable to singing. So I wanted to share and discuss it with you here. And essentially, here's what Bruce Lee said. This is what this MMA fighter used as his guiding light. Research your own experience. Absorb what is useful. Reject what is useless. Add what is essentially your own. This is a beautiful way to look at singing, to make singing work for you. As a voice educator, I certainly form opinions and I form biases, and I try as I might. The human brain is set up to be biased, and the human brain is set up to focus on what I have found to be true and will tend to reject what I find not to be true in my experience. And I really try and make science my guiding light. But science is ever changing. Science is only what we know right here and now. And essentially, at some point in the future, just about everything we know in the here or now is either going to be proved false or our understanding of it will improve. And people would look back at our understanding now just the way we look back at people who, doctors who used leeches to try and cure all different types of diseases. I mean, we can only know what we know. But I try and keep that as my guiding light. But I certainly have my own aesthetic that I like in singing. I believe that what I like to hear is a balanced sound, but there are sounds that challenge that, and those sounds are still valid artistically. So you have to really research your own experience. You have to just be open and be aware to what you find to be true for you. And always allow that to be changed. Don't set anything in stone, but be open, be fluid, but just pay attention to what you're attracted to. The types of vocal sounds, the tone colors, the style, the phrasing, the style of music. When I ask people what type of music do they like, and they say everything, well, that's not true. We don't like everything. I guarantee you, I could find music you don't like and singers you don't like and styles that for the most part you don't like or you don't like as much as other. So just be aware of that. What are you drawn to? Let that be a guiding light for you, as you research singing, as you practice singing. What are the sounds that you want to make? I've said before, as a singer, you just need to be able to make the sounds you need to make. You need to be able to make them consistently and in the healthiest manner possible, and that's it. If your style of music is you just kind of do a low hum and a few grunts here and there, and you have an audience for that, then you don't need to worry about expanding your range and belting high notes. You just need to focus on what it is that you need to do. And don't think that you're going to sing every style. You need to really kind of start to focus and understand what's unique about you. And you're the best person to know that. You are the only one listening to that inner dialogue in your head. You are the only one that feels yourself drawn to things and repelled by others. So just really research your experience. Be open to your experience. And then absorb what is useful. There is so much information out there now. So much on YouTube. And on a side note, I'll interrupt this broadcast. I just did my first voice teacher reacts video on YouTube. I'd kind of resisted it because I thought the space was a bit crowded. But then I always say, hey, each person brings something different to the table. So I'm taking my own advice. I put a voice teacher reacts out there. So go to YouTube and look up John Henny. And it's Bruno Mars, and it's him singing a live acoustic version of Locked Out of Heaven. And the spoiler alert is I'm a big Bruno Mars fan, but you can check that out. Anyway, absorbing what is useful in that whole universe. There's so much information, and a lot of it will be delivered in such a way that this is absolute cast in stone truth. I've discussed before about voice teachers when we go to market and we need to find our own little banner and mark out our own little territory, and taking a stance is a very strong way to come to market. And sometimes taking a contrarian stance and proclaiming everything is false and I have the only truth. You see it all the time, and it's really effective. We as human beings are drawn to this. If I say everything you know is wrong, your brain is going to go, wait, what? You're going to want to know more. Why are you telling me everything I know is wrong? And you have to have your detector up for that. And just not that you shouldn't listen to this person, but kind of find your way to useful information through the haze of braggadocio and marketing, and just see if there's something useful there for you. And then, and this is hard, especially when you're first starting, and this can always change, but reject what is useless. Don't try and learn everything. Don't listen to everything everyone says, including myself. Over these 135 podcasts, I will have said something that for you is useful. And I will have said possibly many things that are useless. And you, it's up to you to take what I am saying and utilize what is useful for you and discard it. It's okay. You may come back and pick up things later. I may be talking about things that you don't at the moment understand or don't really work for your situation. Voice science in particular is something I'm very passionate about, but there was a period early in my teaching career where I was obsessed in developing my ears and just listening and just getting results with the tools I had, and running on an idea of intuition that I would just know what to do for a student. And that worked to a degree. And it kept my head just really focused on hearing and listening and trying different tools. But then the time came when I was ready to embrace voice science. It suddenly became useful for me. And then that in turn replaced intuition, or this kind of stumbling around looking for patterns, even though I got pretty good at it, but it replaced it with more concrete knowledge. And I had more definite answers of why something was happening in the voice. And then I was able to work more quickly. I was able to get results quicker. So that point in my life, voice science became useful, but it wasn't always. And I had tried to look at it earlier and it just didn't make sense to me. And it just seemed too cerebral and academic and just wasn't in my headspace. Be open to what is useful and also what is useless. Again, you're always in your own experience, and allow these things to be fluid. I know Bruce Lee had talked about being like water. Don't be rigid. Don't be set. You know, every moment things are changing. Your brain is changing constantly with every word you hear me say. And as you're sitting there listening to me, whether you're driving or you're taking a walk or futzing around on your computer, every image, every sound, every sensation is changing your brain. And these experiences are fluid. And you just need to be open to it. And then add what is essentially your own. As this all filters through you, what comes out that's yours? Your way of looking at it, your way of practicing, your way of approaching. And as a singer, oh my goodness, in terms of style and artistry, apply this whole process again. What is your own experience? What type of styles are you drawn to? Singers, the way they sing and the riffs that they use, etc. Absorb what is useful, reject what is useless, and then add what is essentially your own. As you listen to different artists and different styles of music, it's all going to percolate inside you and come out in a different way. Don't try and copycat anything or anyone. Don't be rigid in your practicing. If you have a voice lesson and you have, and I recommend this highly, 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 and you've recorded your lesson and you're going through the exercises, do it by a piano. And I recommend learning enough piano that you can play the scale or even just the starting note of a scale. Just know where you are on the keyboard to give yourself a reference point. And if you don't have that, okay, just pause the tape anyway and work the scale, the exercise on your own and try some variations of it. Don't be just a robot repeating what your teacher gave you. I'm not telling you to throw the lesson out, but add your own knowledge and your own awareness to the session. You need to take some autonomy over your voice. I've seen students where they just want the teacher to do everything for them. Tell me what song to sing. Tell me what style of music I should sing. You know, how exactly should I practice? And that's not it. It's got to be about you. You as an artist, you need to start having some strength. You cannot be completely compliant in this process. You need to bring yourself to the table. I've even had students, they'll occasionally push back on me. I'll go to do an exercise and they'll just stop me and go, you know what, can we try this other one? Or can we stay on this exercise a little more? And I'm always open to that. If they feel that they're getting something, even if I'm not hearing it, if internally they're feeling that something is, or that they're working something out, I'm happy to work that out with them. In your lessons, it should be a two-way dialogue. The teacher is not infallible, the teacher doesn't know everything, and the teacher is most certainly not you. Take control, take charge, add what is essentially your own. Hey, if you want to know more about me, please visit my website, johnhenny.com. And you should get my Boldly Belting course. If you want to know how to belt high, strong notes, I've got a new way of approaching singing. There are exercises, but I've also created exercises with words and melody. So it's that stepping stone between exercises and songs. And these little song snippets are specifically constructed to help you find your high, strong belt voice. Go to boldlybelting.com. If you use the coupon code podcast20, you'll save $20. Go get yourself one of those Popeye chicken sandwiches that everybody's fighting over. I guess I became vegan too soon. I shall never know what is driving people to violence to eat this sandwich. Perhaps you can let me know, but I'll just be in the corner eating a carrot. And until next time, to better singing. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.